Now, with respect to the digestive system, the bulk of the viscera contributes to something called the gastrointestinal tract, or the GIT. This is the space starting with the mouth and the oral cavity, and ending with the anus and all structures between that people refer to as the GIT, the digestive tract, the alimentary canal, or the gut. Sometimes you hear it as the gut tube, but oftentimes that's in the context of development. All of these names reference the structures that contribute to this pathway. Now, there are different ways in which we can organize how we conceptualize the GIT. One very easy way is that there are upper and lower portions to the pathway. Those upper and lower portions to the pathway really are going to find a junction right about there. So the mouth, the oral cavity, the esophagus, the stomach, and the first two parts of the duodenum would be the upper GI, whereas the lower GI would be the second two parts of the duodenum, the remainder of the small intestines, the large intestine, the sigmoid colon, the rectum, and the anal canal. Now, we can also conceptualize there being an aerodigestive portion of the pathway. So that would start with the mouth and the oral cavity and the pharynx or the throat. So this would be a common pathway for both the respiratory and the digestive systems. And then there's the digestive pathway that would be everything beyond, so the esophagus down to the anal canal. Now that digestive pathway, we conceptualize as having three parts. So there's the foregut, which would be the esophagus, stomach, and first two parts of the duodenum. The midgut, which would be the second two parts of the duodenum, the remainder of the small intestines, the ascending colon, and about two-thirds of the transverse colon. And then the hindgut, which would be the remainder of the transverse colon, the descending colon, the sigmoid colon, the rectum, and the anus. There are also accessory organs of the digestive system. So these consist of the liver and gallbladder, as well as the pancreas. These are glands that are going to secrete products into the lumen of the duodenum to enhance digestion so that we may have good absorption of materials. Now, the layers of the GI tract are in four parts. There's the mucosa, which is surrounding the lumen. So the mucosa consists of epithelial, or in this case, endothelial tissue. And surrounding that mucosa is going to be the lamina propria. And within that lamina propria, we're going to have mucosal associated lymphatic tissue. And then surrounding the lamina propria, as the deepest layer of the mucosa, is going to be the muscularis mucosae, which is a layer of longitudinal smooth muscle that helps to keep the mucosa in contact with the materials inside the lumen. Surrounding the mucosa is going to be the submucosa. The submucosa is going to be very rich with vasculature, so arteries, veins, some lymphatic vessels as well. And mixed in there is going to be the submucosal plexus, oftentimes referred to as the plexus of Meissner. So this submucosal plexus is going to be the autonomic component, specifically the parasympathetic component that is going to innervate this muscularis mucosae and the endothelium of the mucosa. Surrounding the submucosa are various layers of smooth muscle that we call the muscularis. So these will constitute a very thick layer. And some of these are going to be in circular layers surrounding the submucosa. And some of these are going to be in longitudinal layers. So the longitudinal layers are what's responsible for peristalsis, whereas the circular layers are what's responsible for segmentation, contraction. Now, innervating the muscularis is going to be the myenteric plexus, oftentimes called the plexus of Auerbach. And that myenteric plexus nestles itself between the longitudinal and the circular fibers of the muscularis. And then finally, surrounding all of this is going to be the serosa. And the serosa is going to be the visceral peritoneum that surrounds the gastrointestinal tract and other intraperitoneal organs. And this is going to conduct the neurovasculature from the body to the gastrointestinal tract. Now, different portions of the gastrointestinal tract are going to have variations of these different layers. So we're going to see specializations of these layers, in particular, specializations of the mucosa and the muscularis. And we'll talk about some of these specializations as we talk about these specific layers. Thank you.